This morning in the kitchen, thanks to WaterFire Providence, bringing in Chef Connell Kelly from Emery's Catering. Sit back, relax. We've got a good one for you. Red wine braised short rib. That sounds nice. That sounds like a comfort meal,
right? It really is a comfort food, yeah.
Sit on the couch, enjoy it.
Yeah, but it also, it's a good wedding food, too. I mean, a lot of weddings we do it on, and it always ends up being a big hit. It's probably the most tender piece of beef you'll have. Like, it's delicious.
I know a lot of people are excited, even
just I'm excited if I get to try it.
All right, so take us through the ingredients of what we're going to need for
today's recipe. Okay, so for a braising, you kind of just need olive oil in the beginning, and, like, you brown it in the pan. And then all the ingredients we have is, like, a mirepoix, so that's just roughed up. Cut carrots, onions, and celery. Then we have tomato paste, red wine to deglaze with. We also have my little touch. I throw in whole rosemary and whole thyme, and that goes really well, and it helps build the sauce. And then we have some garlic to finish it, and I have some asparagus and roasted potatoes that are going to finish the dish.
When we hear anything braised, especially two short ribs, is it lengthy? Is it a long amount of time?
Yeah, the recipe that I gave you guys, it says 3 hours, and it will take all 3 hours. Mm-hmm. It's a very rough cut of meat. It's tough. It has a lot of tendons in it. You really need to, you know, cook it for that long, low time, or it will be very rough. Like, this one, you should be able to put your finger through it, and it should be fine.
I love that, though, too. You break it up, it just kind of falls apart, melts in your mouth.
Yeah, it's going to be good.
We can't wait to try it. We're going to get cooking, too, in just a bit.
All right, we are back in the Rhode Show kitchen, WaterFire Providence. Everybody knows it. Everybody loves it. Chef Connell Kelly is here. And we got, you know, nobody is happier than you're making this than me, by the way. So what are you going to do right now?
So I just got to season it with some salt and pepper, and then I'm going to end up throwing it in the pan to get it all braised and brown and start the braising process.
And kind of seals everything together,
yes,
right?
Exactly. And it, if you don't brown it, you kind of lose all the flavor for the meat. And also, it gets really dry really fast, so
we don't want that to happen.
No,
we
really don't.
We don't want that to happen. All right, next up, we also have Liz Silver. You're the event coordinator, Emery's, right?
Yeah, I am.
And you guys are going to be sponsoring, and you're part of WaterFire. I mean, everybody loves WaterFire.
Yeah, it's a great event. We have a really good time, and we're so happy to be partners with them. It's a really great night.
Now, you do events all the time. You cater a bunch of events all the time. WaterFire, that's a big one.
It is.
That's a big one. Tell us what's going to be happening. Because we want to go to WaterFire. We want, you know, a lot of fun stuff. We want great food. That's where you guys come in.
Yeah, we definitely showcase our best meals. We have a bar there, which is great.
Check.
We obviously have some of our guests on the gondola ride.
Right.
So everyone really enjoys it. It's a great event for the state and for the city of Providence.
And it really is nice. I mean, it really is something positive about the state, positive about the city of Providence. You add a bar in there, you add great food, and you're good to go, right?
Yeah, definitely.
Sounds
what
good
else do you need?
What else do you need? All right, the other thing we need some braised beef. That's what we need. We're going to put that together. We're also going to talk with Bronwyn all about WaterFire coming up in just a little bit. Back to you. Hope you're hungry because you've come to the right place. WaterFire Providence is here. Chef Connell Kelly's here. Emery's Catering is the place. Red wine braised short ribs is what we are making. Also, Bronwyn is here from WaterFire Providence. A lot going on because you guys are teaming up with Emery's Catering.
Yes, they've been a sponsor of ours all season long.
That's right.
You know, a lot of people will, and you and I have talked about this before, wonder how they can be part of WaterFire, whether it's from volunteering to doing other things. But we have something called the Brazier Society, which is, you know, when you go to WaterFire, and you've been there before.
Sure, yeah.
It's the reception tent, and we have been so fortunate to pair up with Emery's, who provides incredible food. So for a donation, people can become members, be part of WaterFire all season, help support our season, and they get incredible food, which we're about to witness some of it tonight, because this isn't just what they do for weddings and all the other business they do. At every WaterFire, they are bringing forth the most incredible dishes, so people can support WaterFire, join the Brazier Society, come down, have an incredible meal, have access to those boats.
Yeah, which is such, I mean, it really is, it's such a nice night if you do that.
And they've been a wonderful partner, so they've been a season sponsor and coming in and really just knocking it out of the park. And
with the great food.
And you can smell it right now. I mean, it's like...
It smells so good.
I'm hungry.
It really does smell good. All right, so what are we going to do right now?
Okay, so right now I already have the mirepoix going, and the mirepoix is just the carrots and onions right now. If I add the celery, it will ruin the dish right now. So if you want to take that tomato paste right there, I have a spoon for you.
Sure.
Just take two spoonfuls in there.
Drop that right
throw
in.
Throw that in, yeah, please.
Okay,
just going to turn up the heat a little.
Put that in.
We just got to mix it all together. Tomato base adds a lot of the base for the whole sauce, because with braising, you got to make the sauce too at the same time.
Right.
So this is just going to be the whole beginning.
Okay, got it.
So this is going to get going for a little bit, and then I have, that's some red wine. Now we get the deglaze part. This is the most crucial part. You throw that in, there's all this little burnt particles on the bottom of the
and
pot.
And you want that.
That is, it's called fond. Fond is flavor. It's easy to remember, but if you don't get all that, you're not going to have a good sauce. So if you just want to throw that in, just a little, all not right. all the whole thing.
A little flavor, flavor.
Yep.
Put that in.
A little sizzle's always good.
A little sizzle.
So you just want to move it around a lot, try to like scrape up as much as you can. A lot of it gets on the side from the browning.
And then look at that.
Oh, yeah.
That alone I would eat.
This wouldn't be the best. Really wouldn't. Now we got to take some of that beef stock. You want to pour like half of that in, please?
Mm-hmm.
I'm just going to grab the beef.
Right, while he's doing that, Brandon, you know, we've talked about it before, too. We've said people go downtown Providence, they see Water Fire, they see it all come together, but they don't realize how many people it takes with you and the crew and a ton of volunteers and catering company and everything
sponsors,
else.
And we've added a fire.
To make it as beautiful as it can be.
Absolutely. And, you know, we've added a fire, which we just did in the last month. Mm-hmm. And Emery's right away said, of course, we'll be there and be there at the Brazier Society tent.
Right.
But on Sunday, so Sunday the 4th.
Sunday,
exactly. Labor Day weekend. Mm-hmm. And we haven't done a Sunday fire of full lighting since my tenure at WaterFire.
Wow.
So that's 12 years. And so it'll be like a wonderful holiday weekend. I know all the students are coming back.
Sure.
And everyone's kind of like getting ready to go into autumn and say goodbye to some.
I know. But you know what? A lot of families may be moving their kids back, looking for something to do, looking for a way to experience Providence. What better way to do it than...
And we've got Argentine tango at WaterFire on Sunday. You know, if you come down, I might dance with you, Will.
Okay.
No, it might just happen.
Do that or I'm tangoing with...
Good dancer.
How long has this got to sit in there for?
So I just try to reduce it by half because it's all that stock and that red wine. You just kind of want to meld really well.
Sure.
There's some smashed garlic in there. You want to grab that. Just throw that all in.
Put that
in. Then take a little pieces of butter. Put that in.
Mm-hmm.
And then my little thing that I do that not a lot of people do is I throw in the whole spice. So I take thyme and rosemary right there. And if you just want to throw that in.
Just pop this in just the way it is.
It's going to flavor the sauce. It simmers for 3 hours in the oven, so the more flavor, the better. So.
And when you're doing this, do you need a pan like this, like one of these cast iron
pans?
Yeah,
you really can. Or you can use like a shallow pot. You just need something big enough, because I don't know if you can see, but the rib is pretty big.
Right.
And it's going to, you know, take up a lot of space. But you also need enough space where you can kind of almost, you know, get all the liquid around and move it around.
Don't touch that. We're going to let that simmer away. Guys, thanks so much for coming in. If you're looking for something to do, WaterFire in downtown Providence, a great event that's happening thanks to our friends at Emery. If you want the recipe for this, you can head on over to our website, roadshow.com.